In the last class we had seen how to get the expression for non-dimensional thrust for a turbojet when we had the condition that the flow is optimally expanded through the nozzle. Optimally expanded through the nozzle is a condition that is most times not satisfied. The other condition, that is the flow is choked as it leaves the nozzle, is the most probable one in case of turbojets. Okay. Turbojets, as I had said in the previous classes, other than what was used on Concorde, all other turbojet engines are primarily convergent nozzle. They do not use a convergent divergent nozzle. This is because the exit pressure after the turbine is very low. So, you do not have a scope for using a convergent divergent nozzle. Okay. So, let us look at the case where the flow is choked. Flow at the exit of the convergent nozzle . What does this mean? If the exit of the convergent nozzle, the flow is choked, what does it imply to our thrust equation? If you remember, our thrust equation was F is equal to m dot a into right. This is our thrust equation. If the flow at the exit of the nozzle is choked, then what it means is this part is not going to 0. In all the previous expressions that we had derived, we had assumed that at the exit of the nozzle, the exit pressure is equal to the ambient pressure. That is the condition for optimally expanded flow. Now we are saying that the flow is only choked and P7 need not be equal to P0. So, here P7 is not equal to P0, so therefore it will produce a pressure thrust also. Typically, pressure thrust is around 20 to 25% of the overall thrust. So, this is not a small portion. So, in this class let us look at how to do this analysis when we have this condition. Before we go there, what do you mean by flow in the nozzle is choked? When do we say that? When do we say that the flow through the nozzle is choked?
P7 is greater than P0.
Huh?
When P7 is greater than
P7 is equal to 1.2. P0 is equal to 1. So is this condition choked? And then what do we mean when we say that the flow is choked? Flow through the nozzle is choked. Yes. So, if you have a nozzle, a convergent nozzle, at the exit of it, if the Mach number is 1, then we say the flow is choked. The reason for that is, the reason why we say the flow is choked is, what happens when you have Mach number 1 here, whatever happens in this side, okay, you cannot transmit any disturbance or any information upstream, because the flow has already reached the speed of sound. Disturbances propagate upstream at the speed of sound, right. So, if the flow has already reached speed of sound at the exit, they can no longer the flow cannot feel anything in the downstream conditions. So if m is equal to 1 is reached, then the flow becomes independent of downstream conditions and is only a function of upstream conditions, right. So which is why some people, when they plot the mass flow rate with back pressure, they say it reaches a maximum. That is a little confusing. You just need to say that it becomes independent of the back pressure, okay. Typically if you take any nozzle when the flow is not choked, the mass flow rate is determined by both the pressures. Only upon the nozzle being choked, then it becomes independent of the downstream condition and becomes only a function of the upstream condition, okay. So now let us look at the case on our hand, wherein we have to do the analysis for the flow when the conversion nozzle is choked, and this is our thrust equation, and we cannot neglect the pressure thrust part, okay. So we can again use our we can say that f is still very much less than 1, because most times the main gas turbine engine operates with somewhere around 0.02 or 0.04, okay. So fuel air ratio of 0.02 or 0.04, so f is very much less than 1, so this goes to 0. So we can rewrite our expression as f is equal to m dot a into v naught into v 7 by v naught minus 1, plus I will take out p naught here, so I will get p naught a 7 okay. Now this portion we can simplify as we had done earlier, but in addition we have another component here, okay. So what is it that we do? V naught is equal to E naught M naught, right. So if you put that and M naught is F is equal to M dot A naught M naught and V 7 by V naught, I can express it as A 7 okay. Now using our familiar stuff, that is we know that we assume that gamma and R do not change across the gas turbine engine, so you get A 7 by A naught as an expression in terms of temperatures. So let us do that. I can rewrite this as F by M dot A A naught is equal to M naught into under root T 7 by T naught into M 7 by M naught minus 1 plus P naught A 7 divided by M dot A naught okay. Now what do we do further? What is the condition that we know? We know that M 7 is equal to 1 okay, at the exit of the nozzle, the flow is choked, that is Mach number is 1. Okay. So we can substitute that here and rewrite our expression as M7 goes to 1 here, I can bring in this M0, so I will get only under root T7 by T0 minus this will become M0. Okay. So this is the expression that we have. Now we need to find ratio of T7 by T0 and also P7 by P0. In the earlier case, P7 by P0 we used to take it as equal to 1 and find using that find the ratio of Mach numbers. Now that is not equal to 1, so you need to find two ratios, ratios of temperatures and pressures. Now coming to T7 by T0, we have done this exercise earlier. Now that just that the nozzle exit is choked, do you think this ratio is going to change? Do we need to do a fresh derivation of this ratio, or do you think it is going to change? What is the conditions? It's going to change. Let us see how it is going to change. Okay. See T7 by TT7 into TT7 by TT6 into TT6 by TT5. TT5 by TT4 Now what is this? This is the only place probably it can change. All the rest of the terms are similar to the previous conditions, right. Only thing that will change is probably here, right. So here we know this is the ratio of, we can express this is a ratio of static to stagnation, so we can express it in terms of Mach number. M7 square, then this is 1, this is again 1, afterburner, first one is nozzle, this is afterburner, this is tau T flow through turbine, then tau B flow through combustor or burner, then tau C flow through compressor. And this is flow through intake, which is again 1, and this is theta naught. Okay. Now here we know that M7 must be equal to 1, so we can get an expression for T7 by T0 as tau T okay. Now we also know what is tau B. If you look into your notes, the previous class we had derived this. What is tau B?
Theta B by tau C.
Theta naught. Okay. And if you plug that in, you will get T7 by T naught is equal to tau T. Instead of tau B, I have theta B by tau C theta naught into tau C theta naught. Okay. So this cancels off, and I am left with theta B okay. So this is the expression for T7 by T naught for the condition when the nozzle is choked. Now what happens to the compressor turbine power balance? Does it change because of this, or whatever we had derived remains the same? See, what is happening is something downstream of the turbine, right. So whatever we had derived is upstream of this, so this should not change. So what we had derived for the compressor turbine power balance does not change. So we had derived that from compressor turbine power balance, we had derived that tau T must be equal to 1 minus theta naught by theta B into tau C minus 1. This remains the same. Okay. Now we have to find an expression for tau T here. So let us do that. I can rewrite this as tau T is equal to theta B minus and using this expression into this equation, I will get T7 by T naught is equal to 2 into theta B this and this cancels off. I am finally left with 2 into theta B minus tau C theta naught okay. So we have been able to get the temperature ratio here that we were looking for, right. Now what are the other things that we need to derive here? We have got this part, temperature ratio done. We still have to find the pressure ratio, and we have to derive an expression for this quantity here, okay. So let us do that now. So again, cascading pressures. We are looking for an expression for P7 by P0. We can write it as P7 by PT7 into PT7 by PT6, PT6 by PT5. Okay. Now when we do this, in the previous case we had assumed this, I mean we had assumed the flow to be optimally expanded, so this became 1, okay. Now it is a, it is not equal to 1, so we will get the first term as ratio of static to stagnation conditions. So I can express it in terms of Mach numbers, okay. The next one indicates flow through nozzle. We have assumed all efficiencies, we are doing this analysis assuming all efficiencies to be 1, so this is 1. Again the next is flow through the afterburner, we have not switched it on, so this is again 1. And what is PT5 by PT4? This is flow through turbine, so this is pressure ratio, so this is pi t into PT4 by PT3 is flow through combustor. Combustor the pressure is the same because we are assuming an ideal cycle here, so this is 1 and this is flow through compressor, so this is pi c, and this ratio is for flow through diffuser or intake, this is 1 because we are assuming efficiencies to be unity, and the last term is theta naught to the power of gamma by gamma minus 1, okay. So I can write P7 by P0 is equal to, this is 1. So I will get 2 by gamma plus 1 into tau t to the power of gamma by gamma minus 1 into tau c to the power of gamma by okay. And we do know that tau t and tau c are related through compressor turbine power balance, and if we were to take that into account we can show that the ratio P7 by P0 would be taking into account compressor turbine power balance, we saw that the compressor turbine power balance was unaffected, and we could get this expression for tau t. Now using this in that expression there, we can get okay, I have only substituted for tau t there, tau c theta naught divided by gamma minus 1. So this is the expression that we have. Now we have been able to get expression for two quantities. The last quantity that we need an expression for is, we need an expression for okay. So how do we go about doing this? How do we get this expression? Any ideas? We just like to get an expression for F, you said, we said compressor turbine power balance, and then to get an expression for tau t in terms of tau c, sorry, in the last case energy balance across the combustor, what was what we used to get an expression for F. To get an expression for tau t, we said compressor turbine power balance, and we got the expression. Similarly, is there something that we can do here to get this expression? What we need to do is, we need to look at mass flow rate through the nozzle. We will see how we can use that to get this expression. Now mass flow rate through the nozzle, what is the expression that we know? We know that m dot a into 1 plus f, that is mass of air plus mass of fuel burnt, this must be equal to rho 7 v 7 into a 7, right. Now again we can make this approximation that f is very much less than 1, so therefore this goes to 0, so I get m dot a is equal to rho 7 v 7 a 7, okay. Now what is rho 7 in terms of pressure? M dot a is equal to, using the equation of state I can write p 7 by r t 7 for rho 7 into V7, I can rewrite it as what?
Mach number
into Mach number into
solar stress
reduction A7, right. So into A7, so I get what we are looking for is P0 into A7 by M dot A A0. Okay, so what do we need to do here? This we know is, this quantity is, what is this? Because this is flow is so M7 is equal to 1, so I am left with what is A7? A7 is nothing but gamma r T7, okay. So if I substitute for A7 here and rewrite m dot a, I will get P7 under root gamma divided by this won't be there. RT7. Into A7. Okay. Now what do I need to do? I need to multiply by. If I multiply by A naught on both sides, I get one part that is m dot A naught. Okay. So let's do that. I get m dot a naught is equal to, again a naught is nothing but right. So I will use that on the right hand side. So I get P7 into gamma under root RT naught okay. So R and R cancels off here. So I am left with P7 A7 into gamma into okay. Fine. Now what do we need to do again?
P naught.
So if I I want m dot a by a naught by P7 p naught by a7, right. So I can do this, I can write this as m dot a naught divided by p naught a7 must be equal to p7 by p naught into gamma into under root t0 by t7. Okay. So we have been able to reduce m dot a naught into two known quantities, right. We already know the expression for p7 by p0 and we also know expression for t7 by t0. So we have been able to reduce it to this form. Now let us go back and substitute it and see what we can get. If you remember our expression for f by m dot a naught we had got was under root t7 by t naught minus m naught. This part was taken care of. And sorry, P naught A7 by M dot A naught into what was the P7 by P naught minus 1. So we have got expression for this as well as this. So when we substitute, we get this part remains as is, T7 by T0 minus M0 plus P7 by P0 A7 by M dot A A0 is 1 by gamma into Now we can simplify here and rewrite this expression as we know expression for T naught T7 by T naught, and we also know expression for P7 by P naught. So we will substitute that and see what is the final form that we can get at. Into 1 minus, this is a fairly big expression, this is the final expression that we get. Now if we were to substitute here what we did earlier, that is, does this produce static thrust or not? So let us do that for static thrust. M naught is equal to 0 and theta naught is equal to 1. So if you substitute that, you will get This is the expression that one can get, and further simplification is possible on this. I will leave it as an exercise to you. Okay. You can take out gamma plus 1 and further simplify it. This part also you can take out. Okay. So, we have been able to derive this expression for non-dimensional thrust. Now, this is a fairly complicated expression compared to that we derived for optimally expanded flow through the nozzle, and much more complicated than the expression for ramjet. Okay. Now, the next part that we need to address is what? ISP. Okay. So, ISP part, what we will do is the ISP, we know the expression for ISP by A naught as right, and we have spent a considerable amount of effort trying to derive this expression. We already got this expression. Now, what we need is 1 by f. Now, in the previous case when the flow was optimally expanded through the nozzle, we had derived this expression for 1 by f. Now, what we need to look at is what is the difference between the expression that we derived there and will there be a difference here. Now, again if you look at the flow process, what is happening in the nozzle is much more downstream than what is happening through the combustor. So, the expression for 1 by f that we had derived earlier is the same. So, I can use 1 by f that we had derived earlier as q by Cp T naught into okay. This expression remains the same. So, I know that 1 by f is known, f by m dot a is known. So, if you substitute this expression there, this expression, you will get ISP. Okay, fine. Now, having derived these expressions, let us look at what is it that we can understand from these expressions. Remember, we did the same exercise, we found out what is the Mach number at which the non-dimensional thrust would be a maxima depending on what values of theta b and other things for the ramjet. Let us do the similar exercise for turbojet. Okay. Now, in a turbojet we will again look at the condition where the flow through the nozzle is optimally expanded, simply because it is something that is easier to do in the classroom. Doing something on this is a little more complicated. So, I will look at what we can find out using the expression that we derived for optimally expanded flow. Okay. So, if you look at the expression for optimally expanded flow through nozzle, f by m dot a naught was m naught into theta b minus tau c theta naught plus theta naught minus okay, fine. This was the expression that we had. If you see here, as theta b increases, what should happen? See, as theta b increases, what should happen to f by m dot a a naught? This also increases because you can pull out the theta b terms and you see that you get 1 minus 1 by tau c theta naught. So as theta b increases, it is fairly obvious from this expression that as a consequence f by m dot a a naught also increases, right, which means what? That if you have a large enough theta b, then the size of the engine is going to be smaller and smaller for the same thrust, okay, fine. Or if you keep the dimension same, right, then your thrust is going to increase if you increase theta b, okay. This is preferred because you will have lesser drag on the engine, okay. Okay, then this is fairly clear. Then what we need to look at is what happens to, what is there an optimal value for the compression ratio? If I fix theta b and theta naught, is there an optimal value for compression ratio? Okay, if I am flying at a cruise Mach number, let us say, if I am flying at a cruise Mach number, then my theta naught gets fixed. Remember, when in this previous class, one of the previous class, we had derived an expression wherein we looked at what is the range and how the overall efficiency gets affected by it, right. In that we had said most of the flight takes place in the cruise range, right. So if you substitute theta naught for cruise and you know the theta b value, then you can find an optimal expression for tau c. Let us do that in the next few minutes. So we are looking for optimal value of tau c given theta b and theta naught. So how do we go about it? Again, take a derivative with respect to tau c. So you get minus theta b tau c theta naught. This goes to the power of minus half into the derivative of the terms containing tau c, that is the first term is 0, then you have a minus theta naught, then again you have plus 0 plus plus, because this becomes minus, so you have plus theta b by tau c square theta naught, okay, fine. Derivative with 1 goes to 0, so you get this expression. Now this goes to the denominator because you are multiplying, you have a power minus half. So what you need to look at is only this part of the expression, because for this to be, for f by m dot a naught to be maxima, this should go to 0. This can only go to 0 if the numerator goes to 0, okay. So this is the numerator in this. So for maxima, theta naught must be equal to 0, which means that tau c must be equal to okay fine sorry yeah so you get this condition. So we will stop here and continue in the next class. Thank you.